Hi everyone, and welcome back to the object detection series. I'm YML, and in today's episode, we are going to delve into the world of transformers in computer vision and talk about the DETR model, which stands for Detection Transformer, a powerful end-to-end object detection model developed by the former Facebook AI team, which is nowadays known as Meta AI. So grab your favorite snack, sit back, and let's get into it. All right, let's start by understanding the basic architecture of the DETR. At its core, DETR combines the benefits of both convolutional neural networks and transformers. You may be familiar with CNNs from our previous video, as they are great at handling image-related tasks. But what makes DETR unique is its incorporation of transformers, which has been already proven to be quite exceptional in natural language processing tasks. So how does this combination play out in DETR? Well, let me break it down for you. In the first step in the processing, DETR takes an input image and passes it through a CNN. The CNN extracts meaningful visual features from the image, resulting in a feature map that has a height H, a width W, and a depth C. Pretty standard stuff until now. Then, those features are fed into the encoder of the transformer. But before doing that, because the encoder expects a set of embeddings, they are rolled out in a sequence that contains H by W elements, each one having an embedding size C. Also, as in the original transformer paper, it adds positional encoding to keep track of where exactly each embedding is in the image. After those two steps in the backbone, we pass the features through all the layers of the encoder, resulting into some kind of embedding representation that contains meaningful information about the visual information in the image. Those embeddings are then used by the decoder to detect the corresponding objects in the image. To attain that, the decoder uses some special learnable embeddings called object queries, which act as representatives for the objects that DETR will predict. The best way I can describe those queries is as some kind of experts that specialize in finding objects in some parts of the image. If we take a look at the original paper, we can see in their example that, for instance, the first object query specializes in finding an object in the left part of the image. The next query specializes in finding an object in the center of the image, and so on. Also, it should be noted that the points in those images are color-coded so that the green color corresponds to small boxes, red to large horizontal boxes, and blue to large vertical boxes. Then, for each object query, the decoder predicts 5 values by attending to the visual representations produced by the encoder in the same way as in the original transformer architecture. The predicted labels are the class label and the coordinates of the bounding box. Also, I won't cover the attention mechanism here because I've already covered it in another video. The link to it is in the description if you want to find out how it's done or to refresh your mind. Alright, so now we have the predicted bounding boxes and the class probabilities. After that, the DETR model needs to assign them to their corresponding ground truth object so it knows how to compute the logs. And how do you do that? By taking advantage of what we have learned in the previous video and using the Hungarian algorithm. Well, I hope you didn't get confused because in the previous video, we haven't shown how to do this exactly. But instead we have shown how the Hungarian algorithm can be used to match the bounding boxes in consecutive frames. However, the same logic can be applied here to match the predicted bounding boxes to their corresponding ground truth, based on their intersection over union and the predicted class label. You can think of the predicted bounding boxes as the first frame and the ground truth bounding boxes as the next frame, if you find this easier. Also, if there are more object queries than objects in the image, the ground truth is padded with placeholders that corresponds to no real object. Okay, great. Now we know how to match the predictions to the ground truth labels, so we can compute the loss and train the model. And that's basically the DETR model. I hope you enjoyed this explanation. Please leave a like if you did, share your thoughts in the comments below, and subscribe for more exciting content. See you next time. Bye-bye.